Hey folks, John Ferguson Smart here. I had a conversation today with some folks, and in that conversation, what I found was that we had two radically different views, two different approaches on how to solve the same problem that comes with test automation. The problem is, as you go on with a project, as the project gets larger and larger, as you get more and more tests to automate, how do you keep things under control? How do you keep the tests sane? How do you keep them in check so that it is still possible to automate in sprint and that the maintenance doesn't overwhelm you? Now, one approach to solve this problem is to try and make it easier and easier for the business folk to write test scripts on their own that they can automate without developers having to intervene. And the idea is that this keeps maintenance low, that the developers don't need to, test automation engineers no longer need to maintain these scripts because the business write them. The business write them in natural language. The business write them in fancy tools, and it goes really quickly. The problem with this approach, and what these folk pointed out very rightly, is that very quickly what happens is you get more and more of these test scripts added to your test suite. And what happens then is that they become harder and harder to maintain just because of the bulk of them. You get huge quantities of these test scripts. It becomes impossible to maintain them all. And the teams end up going back to manual testing. So even though the tests are easier to write initially, they become harder and harder to maintain over time. Now, my approach, it's not just my approach, but the approach I like to take is a little bit different. It's to take an engineering approach to the test automation problem and to combine that with a collaboration approach so that rather than getting business to make it very easy for business to write test scripts and hand them off to the developers, just as if the business were writing requirements and handing off the requirements to the development team, we use an agile approach. We get the business to talk to each other. We force the business and we force the teams to collaborate more closely, to understand the requirements and to express them in a way that gives feedback to the business so that the automated tests are a reflection of the requirements. And what happens when we do this? And we introduce the other side of the coin, because just doing that alone is not enough. You'll still end up with large test suites. If you just do a BDD approach and you add lots of new Gherkin scenarios each time and you try and automate them, you'll end up with the same problem, even worse. So you need to combine that with an engineering approach where you build your framework not as a set of test scripts, but as a executable specification framework, which as you build it, you aggressively refactor. Refactoring without mercy. I can't remember the term, but I think Uncle Bob has a term about that. But it's basically pitiless refactoring, maybe. But anyway, doesn't matter. You focus on, as you add new automation, as you add new scenarios, you see whatever you need to do to make your test automation framework solid, to keep it minimal, to keep it slick, to keep it efficient, so that you're adding less and less new code as you go. And I've seen this in action. I've seen frameworks where you have thousands of business rules documented, but the amount of code added is minimal. In this particular one that I'm thinking of, they've got 2,000 or 3,000 business rules documented, executing every day, but they haven't touched the code base in months, if not a year, because they built a specification framework. They did not go and just add script after script after script. So the trick is those two aspects. The collaboration aspect, where you get people to collaborate around writing executable specifications, not just handing off scripts, and the engineering aspect, where you go out of your way, you apply engineering skills, just like you do to your production code. It's no different. Apply engineering skills to build an executable specification framework. Sure, that does take some work and some skill and some practice, but believe me, it really pays off. So that's all for today. Thanks for listening, folks.